Hey guys, welcome to my channel. So this video is going to be about wallpapers because I love wallpapers. I spend hours scrolling website to download my favorite wallpapers. I have collection of different types of wallpapers, like my favorite TV shows, my favorite games, and my favorite celebrities. If you guys also like wallpapers, so in this video I'm going to show you a really cool website from which you can get your wallpapers from. Also, I'm going to show you a really cool time saver trick which you guys can use to download your wallpapers quickly without any effort. So without wasting any more time, let me just quickly show you the website from which I download all my wallpapers from. So the website is wallheaven.cc, and this is not just a yet another wallpaper downloading website. The site contains some really high quality wallpapers and I just love it. Wallpapers are created by wallheaven's user itself, and a lot of UNIX pawn user download their wallpapers from this site. I am a huge fan of this website. I just love spending my time looking for cool wallpapers on this site. The digital art is awesome. The art style is really unique and very cool. So yeah, I was having fun spending my hours looking for cool wallpapers on this website and downloading them. But then I realized,
wait a minute,
I am super lazy. And then I created this pretty cool script which I now use to download my wallpapers. So I named it get wall, and if I press enter, it's going to give me this D menu prompt which is asking for a particular tag or a search query. So for example, if I want League of Legends wallpaper, I can just search for it, and when I press enter, it's also going to give me this another D menu prompt which is just asking for a sort order, like I want to sort by view, by favorites, by top list. So let me just try to, you know, sort by top list.
Hey, listen.
So yeah, I pressed enter and I got this notification that my program is downloading my wallpapers. So this is going to take some time, but it's happening in background, so I don't have to scroll through this whole website to just look wallpaper and download them one by one. This way I can download a lot of wallpapers at once quickly. So here I got all the League of Legends wallpapers which I wanted from Wallheaven website, and look at this, this script downloaded 143 wallpapers. It's written down here, hard to see because the text is very small. So I got all the League of Legends wallpaper, not all but a lot of them, and I am displaying it on SXIV. So yeah, SXIV is a pretty cool image viewer and I use this to see my images. One more thing is that when you download wallpapers from website like this, there's a high chances that you get some wallpapers which you don't like and you might want to get rid of it. So in my SXIV, I wrote this pretty cool script which allow me to do some things. So imagine if I don't like any wallpaper. Let me just see if there is any wallpaper which I don't like. So yeah, this first one I want to just delete it. So what I can do is I can press Ctrl XT.
Hey,
that image does not exist now. So now let's understand how this thing works. So since Wallheaven is a pretty cool website, they provided this pretty simple API. It's version 1, that's why it's simple, I guess. So what this API allow you to do is you can just search any wallpaper and it's going to give this JSON output, bunch of information about that wallpaper, like the user and the URL, and also this path, which is basically the path of the wallpaper itself. So now I can use curl command to search Wallheaven website from my terminal, minus s to do things silently. And here you can see bunch of options which you can give, and this is the main option Q, which is used to give the particular search query. So let me just give cyberpunk because I just want wallpaper of cyberpunk, and if I press enter, it's going to give me some unformatted JSON output, and I can just format it by using JQ, which is a JSON preprocessor. So if I press enter now, it's going to give me the format output, and here you guys can see that the wallpaper original path is basically here in this key path. So what I can do is I can grab path from it and press enter, and now it's only going to give me the links of the wallpaper and nothing else. So grabbing path is cool, but I only want these links, and these links contain some pattern, like it contain this full and then two characters and in the end something like this. So what I did is I simply just use this regex, and if I press enter now, here I'm only getting links and nothing else. And then I can simply just turn it into a variable and pipe it into wget. Sorry, I can't use it right now because I'm in my home directory. Let me just make some temp directory and then do it. So do this quickly again. So if I press enter now, it's just going to download all the wallpapers, the links which you are looking, and let's just cut it. So here it downloaded these two images. So yeah, that was cool. So let's just quickly see the script now, because obviously script contain a lot of other things too. The first thing here in URL, I added this at least is equal to 1080p. So if you look some options here on Wallhaven API documentation, so you can use at least option to set a minimum resolution allowed. You can look for other things too. Like here you are looking at sorting things. So I also created this dmenu prompt which is asking for any particular kind of sorting, and I'm also using this parameter, and I'm using this parameter here. And one more very important thing is that I'm using this pagination here. So Wallhaven don't allow you to give a limit, so you have to run this loop. Like I am downloading 5 pages, but you can obviously increase it to download more wallpapers. By default, I guess Wallhaven download 24 wallpapers, which is pretty less. And I'm sending some notifications too. In the end, I'm just opening it with SXIV with -t, which is used for thumbnail mode. And once I close my SXIV, my script is going to move the wallpapers into my main wallpaper collection folder. So I'm doing this because if I don't like any wallpaper, I will delete it by using my SXIV, and rest will go in my wallpaper collection. And here in the start, I'm just doing some sanitization thing. Like by default, my script is throwing some tags, and these tags contain some hashtag in the start, which is added just for look. So I'm just removing them on line 15. And here I'm getting query from argument. In case if someone is using it from terminal, he can pass the search query from argument. So by the way guys, I'm going to give this script link in the description, but I will not suggest you to just go and download it and start using. Yeah, if you are going to open it and do some change or understand it, then use it. It's completely fine. But without any understanding, I will not recommend you to use this script. All I want is you get the idea and then you create your own script to do it in your way, because I am damn sure that everyone want to use this trick in his own way, because right now what you are looking is my method. So I have like a lot of internet, that's why I'm just downloading all the images in 1080p high quality, but you might don't want to do it, so you have to figure out your own way. The only thing I'm giving you is the idea, and I'm just showing you guys my implementation of it. So the purpose of these videos is not giving you some cool programs, it's just to understand the power of shell scripting and use it in your daily life to make your life simple and easier. Down, yeah. I've been feeling so down, yeah. Can you tell me why? Can you tell me why I'm down?